Okay, in this video I'd like to talk about how to program a timer on and off delay in the EasySoft 7 program that is used for the Eaton Pico PLC. So the first thing I'm going to do is grab an input, just label this PB1. Then I'm going to come down here and grab a timer relay and drag it over to here. And then what I want to do with this timer relay is I want to get everything set for it. So I want to make sure that this is an enable function block on status 1. This will just let it operate normally as an on delay timer. I'm going to come over here, select switch function block. I want to make sure that it's an on delay operation mode. I'm going to select my block inputs, and I'm going to make this 5 seconds. Now I'll come here, I'll select 5. You can see here this is 5 seconds, and if I needed 5.5 seconds or something like that, I could select that range right now. So if I needed 5.5 seconds, I would come here, 5.5 seconds. If my timer was set needed to be much longer, I could change my resolution here to minutes and seconds. Then I can come to my block here. I cannot do a 0.5 second. I could just leave it at 5. I could go 28 minutes and 5 seconds. Basically, whatever amount of time I need, I can create a timer for that. So we'll just leave this at 5 seconds. Then go back to my program mode. The timer should be set, so I'll go ahead and connect the logical path here. So when this push button goes true, the timer will start timing, and this will delay something turning on. What is it going to delay turning on? Well, a contact off of that relay. So I'll select this timer right here, make sure that the status is good, make sure my bit logic is on break since I want it to close or become true when the timing function is done. If I wanted to be the opposite of that, I would put a break. And then I'll just grab an output here and make that logical connection here. Now I can go ahead and simulate this and see if it works. Hit the play up here and then select push button 1 to turn on. And then 5 seconds later, you can see that the timer input went true, activating the output. And this is how an on-delay timer works, and this is how you program it in the EasySoft 7 program. So, and just to run this one more time, you activate this, this goes true. 5 seconds later, this input goes true, activating this. Now, when I release that push button, let's say it's a momentary that I'm holding, let's say it's a selector switch that I put it in there, this will stay true until the timer coil up here is turned off. So I will deselect this, this shuts this off, deactivates that contact off of it, and turns off the output that we have assigned to that timer input. Now, let's see how an off delay works. It's the same timer relay I would drag over here, but the difference is I would come to the switch to function block characteristics, go to the timer relay parameters, select off delay. Now, when I come to this, this will act as an off delay, and there's a big difference between the on delay and the off delay. The main thing that confuses new students is that with an off delay, its normally open contact will go true as soon as this is turned on, and it will delay turning this off by whatever timer you put, whatever time you put in the preset. Let me show you. Come here, hit the play button, activate this. Now, right away, my timer goes true, the contact closes, my output is turned on. It will stay true until I come and I'm going to deactivate this push button. Then after 5 seconds, because that's the amount of time I put in the preset, it will go off. Let me show you again. I activate it, it just goes on, and it will stay true for as long as you need to it. Then when you activate it, it delays the off put the off from going off for 5 seconds. I know that's a little confusing to say and I messed it up right there, but that's how that works. All right, and that's a quick introduction to how timers work in the EasySoft 7 program. Thanks for watching.